More than 2,300 people here in Massachusetts died of opioid-related overdoses in 2022, the most ever recorded. The use of safe injection sites as an appropriate way to address the addiction has been successful in other parts of the world and is starting to get a foothold here in the United States. Somerville may soon open the first government-sanctioned site in Massachusetts, and a 10-year pilot program is under consideration at Beacon Hill. The governor says she's in favor of giving cities and towns the option of opening safe injection sites. Adrian, does this have the potential of opening a culture war battlefront here?
Maybe it does, but I think when you consider 2,300 deaths, that's a staggering number. Mm-hmm. I think it's important to try anything that could help bring that number down.
Jenny?
I think it's premature. There's not enough data. In fact, the federal government just issued a bunch of grant money to study the pilots that have already started in New York City, among other places. Let's see what that data shows before we go down this path.
The Secret Service says the white substance found in the West Wing last Sunday night was cocaine, and now they're trying to figure out how exactly it got there. It was found during a routine search on the ground floor where visitors pass through often. Now, President Biden and his family, they were not at the White House at the time, and former Vice President Mike Pence is among those demanding more information. Is this just embarrassing for the administration? Jenny, let's start with you. Or do you think things could get worse?
I don't think it's embarrassing for the Biden administration. I think it's a huge embarrassment for the Secret Service if they don't track down who dropped that baggie. They have eyes everywhere. It was feet from the Oval Office. Yeah.
What do you think, Adrian?
I agree with Jenny. The Secret Service has to find out where that cocaine came from.
But you don't think this is an embarrassment for the administration?
I don't think so, no.
Here we sit in July. The new fiscal year began on July 1st, and once again, the legislature missed the deadline for passing a budget. Local municipalities, everyone at this table, our stage manager, we're all expected to meet the deadlines for our business or suffer the consequences. Is that the problem on Beacon Hill, Adrian, that there are no consequences?
There are no consequences, and they never meet the deadline, so it's not a big surprise.
Not a big surprise? Wait, is it a surprise to you, Jenny?
I mean, I was up there, and I can't remember how often they passed a budget on time. Very rarely, and it doesn't matter because voters don't care, and therefore the legislators don't care.
Interesting.
It's tough. You know, cities and towns care, though, because they want to know how much money they're getting in their budgets and how to plan.
Then they ought to complain to their lawmakers.
Loudly, yeah.
All right, let's wrap things up with best week or worst week, Jenny.
I'll go with best week. Republicans running for president, giving New Hampshire the respect it is due, unlike the Democratic Party, who is pushing for South Carolina still to go first.
There was one Republican who was not walking, though, in that parade that you're showing right here.
That's a good thing. That's a good thing.
Okay.
Worst week, Boston City Councilor Kendra Lara. You know, if you're going to be a public official, you need to have a driver's license and you need to register your car.
All right. Before we go, there's one last thing we want to show you. Take a look at this picture. On your screen is a picture of Brady, Mac Jones, and Devin McCourty. Two of these guys know something about winning Super Bowls. Collectively, they have 10. But you can see Brady was touching Mac Jones. Will it rub off on Mac Jones, do you think?
Unfortunately, no, I don't think
I hope so, Eddie.
I hope so. Of course, it's July. Football starts this month. Guys, thank you.
Right.
Every Sunday, we go on the record.